It wasn't, however, until I brought the piece down to South Africa and Ford was starting to look at it properly that I started to appreciate, almost through his eyes, the actual quality of the work involved. And I think this is something which Ford has also found, that as he's worked on it, he's actually appreciated the qualities more and more. This has made his job somewhat more exacting than even here he envisaged in the first place.
And I did wonder once or twice whether or not bitten off more than I could chew. But I've not been able to stop. I've set out on this project, and at this point I'm feeling quietly confident. Today I'm going to inlay the remaining eye and the last remaining whisker, two of the most delicate parts of the work. The body of the tiger on the front has had all the shakado stripes inlaid. There's about 50 there now, 50 more to do on the back. And it's really starting to take shape. I'm very pleased with the character that's coming across. But it's been a hugely challenging journey. Okay, so I've prepared the leaves that I'm going to gild today. I'm going to apply the mercury to the areas that are exposed. I've used pigment ink to act as a bit of a resist. So this is the quicking solution. It's a little bit of mercury dissolved in nitric acid and then diluted with water. So I use an earbud and just very carefully apply it to the areas I want to gild. And now you can see the moment I touch it, it goes silver. This is acting as a flux for when I apply the amalgam. This is the amalgam. It's called butter of gold in the old European text. And you can see why. It will take a couple of applications to build up a reasonable thickness of gold. Take a few more applications to get a good solid base of gold, and then it's burnished smooth. So the gold will be very similar to the eyes. Through my involvement with this piece over the last 4 months, and it's been a very intense and lengthy period of time. It's a process of trying to understand what that artist did, why they did it, how they went about it. It's sort of like the old expression, Don't seek to copy the ancients, rather seek what they sought. And as such, entering into this project and creating an utsushi, which is what this is, it's an utsushi is a term used to describe a faithful copy. The fur obscures those stripes most of the time, and they're only revealed as you handle it and turn it around. So it's an incredible amount of labor to create an incredibly sophisticated and subtle effect. I've pretty much completed all of the texture, the fur, all the fine details on the piece are completed. One or two tiny last details around here on the back still to be done, and of course the signature.
We're just about to do the signature. Nerves are a little bit on tenterhooks, a little bit of adrenaline running, but feeling confident, feeling quite steady. Should be good.
I'm making up a new patinating solution. The one I had previously, which was nicely seasoned, was contaminated. So it's a liter of water. The magic ingredient is this green powder, which in Japanese is called rokusho, which generally translates as verdigris, but it's a natural verdigris. It's a copper salt that occurs when salt water acts on copper. It's always a moment before you put it in. Fascinating that you hope you've done everything you can to make sure the metal's clean. And I think he's ready. And all going well, in about half an hour we should have a fully patinated tsuba. I think it's done.